the movie making entries done by the students of grade 8 from various campuses.
Hello everyone, this is a video about one of the SDGs, clean water and sanitation. Hope you enjoy. Here are the 8 targets, and this is the main one. This goal is to achieve access to adequate and equitable sanitation and hygiene for all and end open defecation. Now I would like to introduce one of the actions taken by them. This is a picture of a pipe being built to deliver clean water to areas that lack clean drinkable water. With the help of these kind of actions, many people in the world are now able to have access on clean, drinkable, and usable water. We believe that people must be actively taking part in activities where people can learn about global issues. Providing water brings smile to the world.
Hello everyone, today I'm going to talk about climate change as an effect. As a result of the industrial revolution that kicked off in the mid-1700s and the Earth's atmosphere is warming up at a never-seen-before rate, the major reason for the rise in temperatures is the increase of the concentration in greenhouse gases in the Earth's atmosphere. These cause our planet to retain heat from the sun. Greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide and methane are released in the atmosphere where fossil fuels are burned. Trees and oceans absorb carbon dioxide, which cannot handle the large amounts that are now building up in the Earth's atmosphere. And because our forests are shrinking even less, carbon dioxide is absorbed even less. The higher levels of carbon dioxide are already acidifying, killing off coral reefs. It's also triggering a dangerous rise in sea levels and increase in extreme weather currents. Around the world, innovators are now racing against the clock to invent new ways to live our cities, use lands, manufacture products, and run our businesses. New innovations are bringing down greenhouse gas emissions, confront climate change and its threat to our health and our economies, and creating new sustainable growth and jobs. Thank you everyone for listening to my topic on climate change.
Hello all, today I'm going to speak about climate action. Climate is very crucial for the evolution of the nature and human life. Earth's climate is highly complex that even a small change impacts the entire ecosystem. The main reason for climate change is increased amount of greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, methane, etc. Climate change has led to extreme weather conditions like heat waves, drought, floods, and tropical cyclones, leading to aggravating water management problems, reduced agriculture production, increased health risks, damaged infrastructure, and basic services like education, energy, and transport. There is no country that is not experiencing the drastic effects of climate change. Greenhouse gas emissions have increased to 50% more compared to 1990. Global warming is causing long-lasting changes to our climate system. Goal 13 was established by United Nations in the year 2015, and this one of the 17 Sustainable Development Goals designed for climate action. The main purpose of this goal is to take urgent actions to combat climate change and its impact. 5 targets of climate actions are: strengthen resilience and adaptive capacity to climate-related disasters. Integrate climate change visions into policies and planning. Build knowledge and capacity to meet climate change. Implement the UN Framework Convention on the Climate Change. Promote mechanisms to raise capacity for planning and management. Thank you.
Hello everyone, this
In this video, I'll be showing the clippings of innovation strategy for UAE 2030. They are renewable and clean energy, transportation, technology, infrastructure, education, health, water, and space. Innovation is defined as the aspiration of individuals, private institutions, and governments. First, let's see about renewable and clean energy. For this, I've gone to Masdar City a solar farm to demonstrate the renewable and clean energy evidence. Now, let's see infrastructure. For this, I went to Cornish to film some buildings in this generation and some from our apartment in MBC. Next, let's see about education. Here's our school, Global Indian International School, Abu Dhabi. And space. Let's see the footage of space now. I traveled to Al-Ruwais to record the UAE space station. Here it is. Water. How can we live without water? I filmed two beaches in Al-Ruwais and Cornish. Why beaches though? We can extract salt-free water from the sea through the process of vaporization. I've now combined technology and transportation together. I filmed the Hyperloop car, or autonomous car, which is a self-driving car. Now, I've also combined technology with health. It's biotechnology. That's it, folks. Thanks for watching.
A leader is one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. I consider it as a privilege to invite Deputy CEO of Global Schools Foundation, Mr. Kosta Bodakar, to address the gathering.
Hi, just a sound check. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, we are.
Thank you so much. Hello, everyone. Good morning and good afternoon to you all. I'm honored to speak with you at this virtual Global Student Summit 2020. I'm delighted to note that the focus of this year's Global Student Summit is the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals 2030. As you all know, the Sustainable Development Goals, also known as the Global Goals, were adopted at the United Nations member states in 2015 as a universal call to action to end poverty, protect the planet, and ensure that all people enjoy peace and prosperity by the year 2030. The 17 SDGs, with quality education being goal number 4, are integrated. That is, they recognize that action in one area will affect outcome in others, and that development must balance social, economic, and environmental sustainability. We now just have over 10 years to achieve these goals. And together, all of us, you and me, can and make a difference. In fact, the UN acknowledges this, and I quote, "Everyone is needed to reach these ambitious targets. The creativity, know-how, technology, and financial resources from all of the society is necessary to achieve the SDGs in every context," unquote. I'm deeply impressed by the selection of topics such as no poverty, which is the number one goal, sustainable cities and communities, clean water and sanitation, climate action, affordable and clean energy, industry, innovation, and infrastructure. I watched in awe some of you who you presented their work on these themes. I'm inspired not only by your clarity of thought and expression, but more importantly by your passion. It's a testimony that you are motivated to help achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. Your confidence, poise, and articulation needs a big round of applause from all of us. Indeed, after listening to you, I have no doubts in my mind that the youth in the world today will help us meet these goals well before 2030. Over the last two decades, Global Schools Foundation has done exemplary work in the field of excellence and quality. And today, GSF has become a fountainhead of education excellence with more than 160 national and international quality awards under its belt. This milestone would not have been possible without the strong and continued support of our teachers, parents, and most importantly, you students. We at GSF are highly motivated to continue to do what is best for our students. That is to offer you holistic and all-rounded learning experiences through events like today's Global Student Summit. In fact, our award-winning 9 GEMS education framework specifically caters for events like the Global Students Summit, where our objective is to provide a global platform for our students to hone their talent and share their opinions. Platforms like the Global Student Summit provides an opportunity to you to improve your communication skills, leadership, creativity and critical thinking, and collaboration, the most important 21st century learning skills. Eventually, our students emerge as confident individuals who can share ideas and views that will make a difference to the world. Let me therefore congratulate all the participants of this summit, not just there for innovative exchange of ideas, but also for their enthusiastic participation. All our students have zealously dived into this entire summit, which makes this summit remarkably successful. I would like to thank all the judges for taking time to come and encourage us and our students at this summit. Your advice is highly valuable and greatly appreciated. Congratulations to all the winners who will be announced shortly. I wish them all the very best for the future. In fact, all the participants did a great job, and each and every presentation that I saw was equally insightful. Lastly, I congratulate Global Indian International School Dubai team under the leadership of Mr. Ramesh Mudgal for making this summit a great success. Such a showcase of our students' talent and achievements is a good way to remind ourselves why we do what we do and to give us the enthusiasm to continue on this journey. Let us end this summit on a high note as we remember once again that our mission of achieving excellence is in offering holistic and all-rounded learning experiences to our students who will benefit from them for life. On behalf of the entire GSF family, I thank all the viewers, students, teachers, and the organizing committee for putting up such a great summit. I really appreciate your contribution to make this summit worth remembering. Thanks again to all the judges for being with us today. Let us together continue to inspire each other on this journey of contributing to the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals and reach newer heights in the days, months, and years to come. Thank you and have a great day ahead.
Thank you, sir, for your encouraging words.